Hey guys, Peter here to do an album review. Today I'm here to tell you all about the latest from Orbit Culture, Naya, out August 7th on Seek and Strike. This album has 10 tracks, 50 minutes in length, and this is the band's third full-length studio album. I was really excited about this record, and my expectations were very high as far as the overall sound and quality of this album. Were my expectations met? Well, let's get right into it and we'll find out. To me, this is a record that has to be divided into three main core elements that really push everything, push all the different mechanisms that make this album work, and that is the structure, sound, and vocals. Starting off with the structure, you really have to look at the overall album structure, and that is an absolute roller coaster ride. There are two songs that feel or sound the same or have the same elements in the way they're built, which gives this up and down ride all the way through from the first to the last track. And then when you look at the individual songs, that same approach is present on the individual track basis. A song sometimes will start off very melodic, becoming very heavy, very aggressive, changing again back to more melodic, then changing back into more heavy and aggressive, or the other way around, starting very very intense with a lot of aggression and heaviness, becoming more melodic in the chorus, then changing back again. It's just a record that from a structural perspective is very volatile. It changes on a dime. It changes from song to song in the overall picture of the album, and it changes within each and every individual song. So the two are interconnected, the overall structure and the individual track structure. One dictates the other, and they both push each other in order to create this very dynamic and chaotic record as far as the overall feel and the way it's constructed is concerned. Now, when you move into the sound plays off of that. The sound is as dynamic, as chaotic, if you will, as the overall structure and the individual structure of the record. This is an album that pulls from a lot of different genres. You got thrash metal, metalcore, new metal, deathcore, melodic death metal, death metal. All of these genres play a role in how the sound is created on every single song. Every song has a different fingerprint, every song has a different DNA, every song brings something to the forefront. So when you tie in this volatility of sound, this volatility of approach, this volatility of influences into how the record is structured on the individual basis and in the overall basis, you have a record that just goes anywhere it wants to go. Now, normally on an album like this, my main concern is always that it's going to feel very broken, that there's no red line all the way through, that this is a record made up of 10 singles that don't necessarily feel like they belong together or that they're a part of a full-length album. That's not the case with this record. I honestly felt that while as dynamic as it is and as chaotic as it is, you can still find some elements that are common on every single song. And those elements, while perhaps not being the driving forces of the sound and of the record, they're enough in order to keep the album very cohesive all the way through from the first to the last song and still feel part of a bigger picture and not just a collection of 10 tracks. One of those elements is the vocals. The vocals are one of the main driving forces, but they're also one of the elements that really brings some cohesiveness to the overall feel of this album. I love both styles. I love the clean vocals, I love the harsh vocals, but I have to say the clean vocals are just outstanding. Songs that are dominated by the clean vocals have such a melodic impact to the overall feel of the album, and then the songs that have more of a harsh vocal predominance give a lot more aggression and heaviness to the record. The tracks that blend those two elements to perfection are really the bridges that connect all the other tracks together and allow this album to feel as one, and like I said, not just a collection of 10 tracks. But if I had to pick, my favorite vocal approach is definitely the clean vocals. I just love how they sound, I love the melody that they have, and in some cases, the melancholy that they transport into the songs and bring out of the lyrics of those same songs. I just love the vocals all around. If I had to define this album, I would define this album as a Jason Statham record, because I felt listening to this album that I was watching a Jason Statham movie, and the last song on the album is an instrumental track, which would be the credits rolling all the way down. It's just an action movie into a musical record. That's what this is. This album feels like an action movie. It just moves all over the place, ups and downs, roller coaster ride. You don't know what's coming around the corner. Each song becoming a chapter, and you don't know within that chapter what's going to happen, what's the next action scene is going to be, when there's going to be a love scene, when is the movie becoming a little bit more dark and somber. It's just moving in so many different directions that the best way to describe this record is as if it was an action movie. That is my way of approaching this album. So were my expectations met? 100%. I love this record. One of the strongest, heaviest albums that I heard this year. One of the most driven records. One of the most dynamic. One of the most complex. And definitely one of the most diverse albums of 2020. As far as songs are concerned, I want to start off with the opening track on the album, At the Front. I love this track. Heavy, aggressive, demolishing at times, mixing melody and aggression, changing some of the elements to really provide this track with the needed dynamic mechanisms in order for this track to move in and out of melody and aggression. The chorus on this song is very melodic, both from a musical perspective and from a vocal perspective. It really offers a break from all the heaviness that the track has surrounding that chorus. The guitar solo that follows the second chorus is magnificent. It really blows up some melody onto the track, but it mixes a little bit of the two worlds that this song has, the more melodic side and definitely the heavier side. And it's the perfect way of closing off the track, because from that solo, the song kind of dies out and it closes off. So it caps this song into perfection. Really a great opening track, not super heavy, but still very dynamic and aggressive. This is one of the keywords for this record, is really aggression, because this is a very aggressive record, even on the songs that are not as heavy, that are more melodic or melancholic. The next song is North Star of Naya. I love this song, so beautiful, heavy track. It doesn't have the same tempo, it doesn't have the same approach as At the Front, has a more methodic approach in my opinion. The chorus is absolutely brilliant. It gives me a little bit of a Linkin Park feel and how it sounds as far as the melodies and the way they're constructed, but also even from a vocal perspective, I got that Linkin Park feel, that new metal feel surrounding this song, specifically with the chorus. I love it, I love how it's constructed, and I love how it's delivered. This allows the song to still be heavy, still be aggressive, definitely more driven in the verses, but then alternating approaches and alternating sound with a chorus being the heartbeat of the song, being a lot more melodic, using clean and harsh vocals. In the chorus, you have the clean vocals really dominating everything, being in the forefront, with a little bit of harsh vocals just sprinkling in behind as backing vocals in order to just give some texture, a different feel, if you will, in how the chorus works. But in my opinion, that adds a little bit of more intensity. It definitely adds a little bit of more flavor to how the chorus comes across, and it makes it a lot more impactful and it makes it a lot more memorable. Last but not least, Mirror Slave, one of my favorite songs on the album, if I don't count the singles that the band has released. The riff chugs, the track chugs, heavy, intense, not necessarily moving at a fast pace, but it's chugging along and it's heavy and it's coming at you with every single note. I love that approach that this song has. The clean vocals give this track a more somber atmosphere. The harsh vocals are sprinkling in to give some texture, to give a little bit of a different dynamic as far as the vocal approach is concerned. But this is a predominant clean vocal track, and I'm glad it is, because they work magnificently well, not just with the sound that the song has, but definitely with the atmosphere that this track has surrounding it. Following the second chorus, you get a little bit more intensity. The song changes almost completely, becoming a lot more aggressive. The tempo moves all the way to 11. It becomes a faster song. The clean vocals still dictate the atmosphere. They still dictate where this song is going. But the music that surrounds them definitely changes. And this is a song that's divided into two halves. The first half more methodic, more melancholic. The second half more aggressive. A different reflection, if you will. The first half giving you a more calm reflection, the second half in that Mirror Slave giving a much darker, more intense reflection of what this song is all about. So definitely a track that's divided into two. This is it, guys. This is Orbit Culture with Naya, out August 7th on Seek and Strike. Let me know your thoughts on the singles, on the album. What are your expectations for this record? Any questions that you may have that I may be able to answer, put those in the comment section. I'll be reading those and getting back to you as soon as possible. Take care, guys.